Hello viewers, welcome to the channel Sampoorna Adhyayan. In this video, I am going to tell you that how to create the new projects and the schematic file in AutoCAD PSPICE 9.2 full version. In other videos, I have already talked about that how to download and properly install this AutoCAD PSPICE 9.2 full version, and I have also given the link to download there, so you can follow that video. The link is given in the description box. And for the other AutoCAD PSPICE related videos, you can visit the channel page, and you can also watch the playlist related for the PSPICE related videos. So let's start with the how to create new project and the schematic file in 9.2 full version. For that, I need to go first of all for wherever my Capture CIS is installed. So you click on the Capture CIS. It will take a few seconds to open. Now here with the very first time, you have to access the file menu and you have to create new project. So just you click on the new and then project. It will ask to you that what type of project you want to create. So you have to select analog and mixed AD, and you can give the project name, like I can give project 1, project test 1. Okay, now we have to locate the directory location for this also. I have already given it, so you can browse and you can give the directory location also. So you can also create the directory in the corresponding folder or wherever you want to create. Like if here I want to create a directory, then I can create directory with the name testing 1. So you can create it, you can select this testing one, or you can select this one, whatever you want. So I'm going to select this testing. Okay, now okay. Now here it will ask that create PSPICE project. So here you have two options: create based upon an existing project, and second option is create a blank project. So you have to select the create blank project for this. Okay. Now as soon as you click on this OK, you will be able to access your schematic file. You can see that the page now is open, is nothing but your schematic page. You can zoom it, its active area will become zoom for you. Here on the very right side vertical menu, lot of options are given: pointer, add part or place part, place wire, and different other connection, place bus, and the ground connection also is all given. Several other options are also given. So here you can like add your components and you can create your schematic. And to run that schematic, you have to save that one with some new simulation profile. So you have to go into the PSPICE menu, click on the new simulation profile, and you can name that simulation. Like I'm going to give a testing underscore project 1. If you give this new simulation profile, it will create a new simulation profile for that schematic. Create it. Now as soon as you create, you will be able to see that there is this kind of a menu will be open. Here you can set up that what is your runtime. Like if I want to run for 100 milliseconds or whatever, NS means nanosecond. You can also give the maximum step size of the simulation. Different other options are also there. Later we will discuss about this in the other videos, that what are these options. And you can give the simulation profile that your runtime will be 100 millisecond, at maximum step size is 0.01, that means near about 1 millisecond also. You can give as per your project, and you can apply and you can okay. Now to run the project, you have to go to the PSPICE menu again, and you can run by this option, or you can press the F11 also. Other thing is that if at any time in between of the project, if you want to edit your simulation profile, so you have the option of edit simulation profile also. You can go back to the simulation profile. Like if I want to change the duration, I can change it. I can make it for 500 milliseconds. So this is the way I can change the step size also. Whatever be the things related to this menu, you can change it at any time by the edit simulation option. From where you get it, PSPICE, edit simulation profile. So this is the way you can save it, and you can again save for your project, and you can close. Now if you sometime if you close it completely, and if you want to access it again, that where my project is saved, so you have to go to the file menu again. You have to go to the open option. Now project, now you are going to open your project. So I have made a folder here, testing one. You have to go inside that. You will find your project created by you just minute ago with the .opj file. You can select this file and open. It will open this hierarchy file is there. You can see that we have made a project with the name, its schematic name is page one, and you have made it with the project test one. So you can click on this. The same file will be open up over here. So in this way, and you can also see that its simulation profile is same. You can see that the same simulation profile is there. Okay. So in this way, you can access again your saved project. So this is the way so that you can create your new project and schematic. So this is all about this video. In the other videos, I have already told about that how to download and install it properly. In other videos, I also told about that how to work on the different projects. So please keep watching, and please subscribe the channel and press bell icon for the further uploads. Thank you.